I ran into Benjamin Bartholomew the other day. And you know something? This Benjamin Russell Bartholomew were arrested back in the spring for standing on a sidewalk holding a sign that says taxes equal theft. Now, whether you agree with that or not is not the issue. The fact is, do we have a right in this country to do that? Our founding fathers felt that we did, but today it's questionable. And their case keeps getting continued. Now, let me help you with this. Whether they're found guilty of anything or not isn't even the issue anymore. What the issue is will you ever stand up with a sign like that because of what they are now going through? Because they've now hired attorneys. They've now made several trips to the courthouse. They've made trips to their attorneys sorting this out. Maybe you think, well, why don't they just pay the fine and be done with it? Well, because, you know, I was talking to a good friend of mine that works for the county. And he said, you know, I would never plead guilty to anything I wasn't guilty of. In other words, I wouldn't accept a plea bargain.
Right,
Or plea to something less. Because ultimately, you pled to it and you're stuck with it. And when you talk about your rights being violated and you give in to that, you have just changed our system from a system of freedom to a system of totalitarian regime. And you think, oh, well, that's overstating it. Once somebody that a friend of mine, a friend of his, said the other day, he's also acquaintance of mine, said, I listen to Lou's radio show to kind of see what he's saying, but he's way over the top. Honestly, I think maybe other people ought to be over the top. I think our freedom, our rights are very important. And many times when people are exercising the rights that we do have and we don't exercise them, we think they're radical or they're intense or they're over the edge. And honestly, I think a lot of our founding fathers would weep over the fact that we have just surrendered our rights to the government. And let me tell you something. If this case even is dismissed against the Bartholomew brothers for dogging them for a year, I bet this thing goes clear a year.
Yeah, yeah.
How many people you think that are following this will stand up for their rights knowing that they're going to get drugged through the court system for a year? What happened to swift justice and sorting these things out? What it is judicial intimidation is what it amounts to. And so pretty soon, like we did this, so we got involved years ago in what they called Operation Rescue, which was going out in front of abortion clinics. And once you get arrested a couple times, a lot of people that were pretty zealous to do it in the beginning, to stand up for the rights of the unborn, they lose their zealous nature. They lose their zeal because they know that, well, I got a job and now I'm going to have to go to court and I'm going to have to pay a fine or I'm going to have to serve some time. And so the system wears you down.
Yeah.
And so whether you get found guilty or not of some of these things, your rights will be taken away from a government. That's why the founding fathers were concerned as government grew and as people yielded their lives to government management of all elements of their life, we would lose our freedoms. And anyway, the Bartholomew brothers are going back to court in February now. It's now set for February because their attorney, because they're going to take it to court, right? And the district attorney did not want to take it to court because he doesn't. Actually, it's going to be embarrassing for the county. But the defense attorney has asked for all the, you know, they're getting ready to go to court. They want all the evidence, right? So they're asking for all the police reports. What did people write down? And so now it's going to take like 4 or 5 months to sort that out, right? It's now December, but or maybe not 4 or 5 months, but at least through January and into early February before they go back, and maybe they won't go to trial, maybe they will. But the damage is done in terms of freedom unless we have other people like the Bartholomews that are willing to stand up. To me, it's interesting how they were selective in the protest, you know, because they certainly haven't ever arrested any of us when we held up abortion kills children. We've done that since 1987 annually, and no one has ever been arrested. We've had some irate businesses that didn't like the idea, but we just quit shopping at those businesses since they didn't like it, even though we weren't blocking their driveways. They just said, we don't like that, and you shouldn't be standing out here on the sidewalk like Burger King and people like that. So that was easy to eliminate burgers from that corner.